Bezos has already proved his Blue Origin rockets can reach the edge of space and, crucially, return to Earth in one piece. The cost of funding his pet project is stratospheric. Addressing a space symposium in Colorado Springs, the Amazon founder revealed where the money was coming from.
I saw about $1 billion of the Amazon stock, and I used it to invest in Blue Origin. So, the business model for Blue Origin is very robust.
Yet Bezos went on to outline his vision of a sci-fi future made real, in which companies like Blue Origin become profitable and self-sustaining. He said it would be a long road before that was achieved, but he was happy to invest to make it happen. Only time will tell if his money has been well spent, or
working class parents, bottom line, they just want their kids to do well at school, they want them to succeed, get a mortgage, pay the rest of the thing off after 20, 25 years, and have a bit of a life.
They will be filled by rich people, those who can easily afford, despite a 20% increase. You know, for hard-working, middle-class, low-middle-class parents, they're going to find it more and more difficult, they won't even think about it, so they'll be forced into pursuing the state education route.
Listening to that might be Kenneth, the chair of the Headmasters and Headmistresses Conference, the body that represents fee-paying schools. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
What do you say will be the consequence of putting VAT on school fees?
Well, I think the idea of supporting young children and to make sure they're ready for school and able to learn is something we absolutely support. But this particular idea of Labour, yeah, was based on dodgy bits of misunderstanding. And I think we can your piece illustrates how that can be done.
What do you say the actual tower?
So your piece of mother explained that family is working hard to send their child to a primary school, so 20% height increase would make that impossible. That would be the case for tens of thousands of families around the country, and those students would go into the state sector, and the result of that, I think, will actually be this would be a net cost to the state.
And yes, as you know, tens of thousands of people come to this country from abroad, very rich people, in order to send their kids to private schools. Millfield has an equestrian centre, Snow has a golfing course, and Shelter House has its own stables. Why should somebody go to work on the minimum wage today in order to subsidise those very rich children going to very privileged institutions?
So let's deal with one that's your perpetuator, one of this, if I may say so. So over a fifth of families with children in private schools earn less than £50,000 a year. That's still a lot, according to the comparison with the median family income. But it's not that in the uber wealthy cap. And the majority of those parents have both parents earning about a third of the people who are going to private schools to be paid presumed fee assistance. I think, again, going back to your piece, I think that mum would say she had no choice but to seek private education. And that is the point. Most of the parents in my own school fall into the category of hardworking, dual income parents, have not gone to independent schools themselves. They are working very hard indeed, and they will be penalised by this, and it won't work.